Dave Hooks, it's Rithgar here. How you doing? Welcome back to Transport Fever. Right, we'll deal with that in a bit. We know that we've got some deliveries coming in here, so we can focus on those to start with. I want to make this next route, so there's another line. Like that. First up, we will go there, the Santa Cruz. And then I'll add that one in. So I don't know if this works. I don't know if this is a thing. Somebody did say that I can do it like this and it will work. Whether this is true or not, I don't really know. So I'm going around several of the bus stops. It's on the outside. So I want to go to that one there. And then we'll go to that one over there. So, like, I've kind of, like, gone round several of the bus stops. I don't want to go round all of them like I am with the actual buses. I think that's fine. We'll see if this works. It may not. This may or may not be accurate information that I have been fed and funneled. So then from there, I will buy road vehicles. And this time, we will colour them blue like that. And we will buy four I'm going to put on here. 2, 3, 4, like that. I suppose I could do 5, but I don't want to. Because this should allow me to, you know, just in case I want a truck for something else, like somewhere else. I mean, yeah, we'll worry about that later. Set line 4. Like that. Let's remove you. And then I want to go to there, and I want to, replacement vehicle is the Opel Blitz, okay. You are going to go to 25%, and automatic replacement is now on. So those are automatically being replaced as well. This line here is currently at minus 4,000. That one is currently at minus 15,000. So there's some more lines gone in there. Let's kick these off. There's my new fleet of trucks coming out. Oh, they look fantastic. Look at the colours on them. Also pretty. Okay, that does look very cool. I'm very pleased with that. We're not going to have anything over here just yet. The green ones are not going in there. The blue ones are going in here. In they go. The green ones are going on up the road. They're just going to go around. There's nothing else that they can do anyway, apart from go in there and then start moving. Those trucks have got a long trip. So let's go down to just play speed like that, because there's some other stuff that I can set up. I can set up a cargo ship. I can get a cargo ship running. To enable rail... Oh. I need a truck going from over here, so maybe I shouldn't have had quite so many trucks running over this side. I should probably have had 2 trucks running on that one, except that I'm focusing on getting that one done first. Bring visitors to the snack bar. I've now got a visitor over there. So I don't have any there. Collect livestock. 12 livestock collected and on their way back. That one's going around. They're heading off into town, so they're not going to do anything. But I've got livestock. They're coming up. Oh, they've already gone and taken 12 livestock and moved them. He's coming in. He's got 11 that he can take. What's he going to carry? He's got 0 of 11 there for timber. There's livestock right there. He's got 11. You, the next vehicle, you've got 0 of 11 on there. That's grain that one's taking. And then this one here, this one, again, is saying 0. It's not got any. It's not like identified as anything just yet. It's waiting for the grain to go through. What have you got? You've got 2 cows and you've got 3 of each. So we've just got to wait for that one to finish processing. Now you're off. You in here, I've taken 3 cows. We can't take split loads on this. Can only take one or the other. So he's only got 3 livestock on there. But that's good. So I've collected some livestock. We've moved them off. I've got 14. Oh! 14, 11. That's how many I've collected from there. That's how many are actually in the depot waiting to be picked up. That's what that's all about. Right, well, that's okay. That makes perfect sense. And then you in here, that's going to be bring visitors to snack bar. I've now got that one. That one's up and running. That's going. That's another excellent bit of progress. So that one there, I need ore and I need coal. Coal comes from over here. At the moment, I've got 1 truck that I can do that with. Just a single solitary truck. I could go and get, sell some from the other place and bring them over here. Let's set up a route first. So I want to go over to here, and there's little point in setting anything up just yet because I need to get the depots. So that's the steel one right there. That enables rail construction. Make road construction possible. I need slag, which means I got to start this one up first. This one is needed so that I can get the slag production. So I do need this road one down here. We've got to have that one. So let me go. I'm going to make a road around there. All right, this is all I got. I got a small country road. I've got... That's it. That's all I've got is a small country road on there. Take me home, country road. There we go. It took me home. I'll put that one onto there. That's going to be just fine and tickety-boo. And then you, truck station. I need to put a truck station down here. And I can put that one a reasonable amount away from the coal factory. The coal mine. And then I can do the same over here. I'm going to put another one of these down over here. So I bring that one, and that one can drop down there. That's far enough away. Oh, wait a minute. I also want to be able to take into account the docks, don't I? See, back here, it's not taking into account the docks. So I'm going to put that... I'm going to put it there. Although I think the docks kind of work the same. I think you can just have... Wait a minute. Do the docks count? Let's see. Can I use that as a road, like a road line? Go to you. Line 5. There. Oops. There. Right. Docks over there. I'm going to do this one first. Is that one. And I'm going to bring you down over here. Station types don't match. Right. That doesn't work then. Wait, what? Station types don't match, e.g. bus stop and train. Oh, train set. Right. Okay. That's fine. So no, we don't want you on the route, which means that I do need to go and build the stop. But I'll put it down this side. Down here, I'll put it there so that it's close to the docks, which means that if I put it there, it's not touching the docks. I need that hash the grid to be touching the docks there, I think. So if I drop that one in there, that should then work. And then I go like this. I go to line 5. Let's move you a sec. And add in that route right there. That's done. That's perfect. So what else do I want to do? I want to put in a road depot. And that road depot can go in here. I can put that for 105,000. I don't think so. I don't think so, Sunshine. That's 20,000 there. If I put it all the way up there. Or I could just put it down here somewhere on the flat. Like there. That's like 11,000 down there. 11,000. That's perfect. That's much better. That's much, much cheaper down there. Right, I've got one truck that I'm allowed to buy from here. Opal Blitz. That's got to be dark blue. Buy, and that's it. I've run out of vehicles that I can actually buy. So for now, I'll go set line all and go to line 5 like that. There isn't a lot that I can do with you, and I don't think I'm going to be able to set this one either. Right, go to there. Replacement. See, it won't let me select a replacement on it, so I can't automatically replace. Which makes me think I may not be able... That the automatic replacement may not work on those. Line 3 is profitable. Those... None of them are profitable at the moment. Okay. He's heading off, and he's going to start slowly getting a bit of coal over to there. I will change around the vehicles with the livestock and stuff later on. Let's see. I've got 3 running up and down the road over here. Right now, you've got 9. You've got 3 grain. You've got 9 cows. And this one heading back, that had a bit of grain as well. I'm thinking that only 2 trucks is needed for that particular line. There. You going in here, you've 11 of 11 on there. And in here, I've got 8. So I don't think I need that many in there either. So that one right there, that is empty. I'm going to send that one back to the warehouse and I'm going to sell it. So you're going to turn around and you're going to be sold. And then you can go out and work on the coal line. And I will just have two trucks running up and down on here. The four on the other one, I'm going to leave them where they are for now. I've got four visitors gone to the snack bar. Livestock, we've delivered 31 of 50. What was the livestock? What are we going to get from there? You can then deliver food produced by the factory to commercial areas of surroundings. He's going to get us an aeroplane. Right, so he will get us one aeroplane, which is awfully good of him. Airports have got to be operational again. At least 10% of the demand for construction materials is covered. So I've got to make construction materials available over here, which is back to doing this one. And then we'll be able to get that one there working. So, yeah, you're just going to have to keep going backwards and forwards. Details. Potential 50. Right, we've got incoming there. I have one ship that I'm allowed to use at the moment. Just one. I'm not allowed to use any more than that. Just a single solitary boat. So we will go to our boats right here, and we will go to that one right there that allows me to go and purchase said boats. And I will drop you dock outside of navigable waters. 12, 11, yeah, see, it gets much more expensive there. 11.4k, dirt cheap that one was. Right, cargo ships. Well, I'm going to want ore going from there down to here. That's got to be my first one, so that I can get the steel mill up and running. Because I can't produce the slag that is needed over here without that one running. That's got to be our first one. So we're going to want one route going between those two. I've got some more visitors gone up. We've got some more livestock gone up over here. This is starting to look good. You, what are you carrying? You're carrying 11 coal. You know, I don't actually need another truck on here at the moment. Details. Potential 70, stored 0. Yeah, I'm not going to spend money on another truck, because it's like 100,000, so I won't do that yet. I'm going to build another route. Line manager there, so we've now got a pink line. That one is going to go from that harbour to that harbour over there. So we've got that one route right there. That's going to be my cargo ship. It's going to be running between those two. So I will go here and I will go buy ships. This is the only one I can use. It's the Klondike. Color has got to be the pink right there like that. And compartment one and compartment two. I've got two separate compartments on here, which I can configure. So I could take stone and ore off of there. I could bring that over to here. And then I could bring both of those over to here. Is that close enough to deliver the stuff to that one? Or am I going to need a road vehicle? That's also... I'm going to do that. I'm going to have it running between the three. This one over here, I'm not going to be bringing anything over to that one just yet. We are going to want grain over there. But there's the Klondike, so we can... We'll just leave that one. Let me go back to here and go to line 6 a second. And add in another line over here. Right, that seems to be a very looped kind of weird line. Collect livestock task complete. You go to there. And then you go to there. Right, that's a better route. I run around in a circle like that. Whether that's actually going to work properly, I don't really know, but we will see. So let's remove you from there. And you from there. And then I will go to there, and I will... Oh, buy ship. I didn't actually buy the ship, did I? So you need to go to that color right there, and then we buy for 500,000. That is the only cargo ship that I am allowed to use. I don't know what the lifespan of the ship is. I forgot to look. Right. Set line all line 6. Off you go. So the Klondike is going off to... Oops. Going off to line 6. We turn round so that we can see it in the sunshine as it comes out. There it is in all its glory. In all its boaty glory. Go a bit faster. I'm out of there. Right, there. We have our new boat. And it's away and it's looking fan-shmabulous, is it not? That's brilliant. Right. You keep doing what you're doing. This one over here, aeroplanes, I've now got... So I've got 3 and 3 in there with our 2 trucks running up and down. That'll be fine. We can leave it going like that. This one is producing food. We've got a... Is the food actually being moved? There's 6 of them. You got 8 on you. And you're coming up to the first bus stop. It does. It works. We just use the bus stops. Okay, well, that's really good. I got people up over there. I've got 10 of 50 delivered to that one. We need to deliver grain. We do have an aeroplane that we can use, but we don't yet have the other stuff available over there. I don't need to worry about that one. So I've got that boat. Boats take a ridiculous amount of time to go anywhere, by the look of it. An absolutely ridiculous amount of time. I can build a bridge all the way across there for 22 million. I'm not going to, but I can in theory. So how much does it cost to go from this city? Pillar collision. Doesn't like that. It won't let me do that at all. Maybe I need to start it from... Oh, I need to start it from down here. So I can do that. That's 40 million over to there. It's 43 million. 4.3 billion to build it up there like that. That's brilliant. 40 million. I wonder if the ships could go underneath the bridge if I do that. Right there, 40... 39 million across there. It would be possible to build a bridge all the way across here. It is a possibility. That's 49 million over to there. Let's go from that side because it might be cheaper. 33 million down to the coast down there. So it does depend a lot on the elevation. So if I bring it out from that point there and I go straight across there, I can get that at 22 million right there. There's probably the cheapest bit there is 26, 24. 22 million right there. All right, I can bring that all the way down and that just goes to the edge of the land right there. 22 million going right the way across. So, in theory, that's possible. That would be pretty cool. That boat is... Right. Let's speed things along a little bit. I don't think there's anything else I can do for a moment. I've got my one cargo ship going. I mean, I suppose I could put another truck... Actually, you know what? We do need to start moving some stuff up here so that I can get some things stored. But then that would mean having my ship going around an extra route. I want more boats, really, don't I? Steel is being brought back to here, plus slag and stone over there. Which means that this ship over here is going to take a long time to do any trips. And it's going to run around most of it empty first. So what have you got? You got 22. I'm just about to bring in one more lot down there. There we go. There's another 11 just being brought in right now. Around you go and unload. That's straight into here. Details. 33 in there. It's coming up round and going. Yeah. Very, very painfully slow on the boat transport. So if we can make bridges later, that is definitely going to be something that is going to be profitable. Okay, the truck line here, that's profitable. Line 3 is nicely profitable. The bus line is profitable. That one there, I've barely breaking even. Currently, the ship is not really... Well, yeah, hasn't made any deliveries or anything yet, so that doesn't really count. You in here. Details. Potential 320. So, well, I mean, we could do with getting more stuff delivered here, couldn't we? How are we doing over this side? I've got all of these running up and down. I've got 20 cows, 62 grain. I do want to get some grain traveling all the way up through to here into a storage line up here somewhere. And making use of things over this side. Let's just slow that down a wee bit. Because I need to be getting grain going across there. But I don't think I can get more ships. Road construction. Deliver grain there. No oil. Large amounts of grain. Yeah, I'm going to have to start getting grain delivered up over here somewhere. So there's got to be another route that we've got to form. So I want to take you right there. And it's going to be a truck station. I'm going to bring that in. Well, I can drop a truck station there, and that does actually cover that plant as well. And then I can make a route for that truck line. So I got one on there, I got two on there. I could remove one of those on the food one. That might be a positive thing to go and do. Not sure yet. Anyway, new line. A bright red line this time. We're going to go from that one, and that one is going to go to that farm right there. Don't have anything else that I want to do with it at the moment, so you can just stop like that. I will then go and buy a truck down here, buy road vehicles, the Opal Blitz right there. It needs to be red. I will buy that one. Set line all onto line 7. And that should start moving grain up through. I mean, I can specifically set it to only move grain and not move anything else at all. You don't have anything on you at all. That one can take up to 100 items at one time. This one over here has already got a load of ore lined up and ready to move, but it does not have any stone yet. Despite the fact that, well, the ore will go from there, the 72 ore. It'll go from there and it'll go over to here. So we'll be moving ore, but we won't be moving. So I don't think I need to be moving this one. Although I'm doing that because it's moving steel over. But I don't need the steel over here until such time as I've got that one. So I think, really, this route here, my best course of action right now is... Oh, but then I'm also moving the slag over. No, I will leave that one in the route. Despite the fact that right now it's not doing anything useful, it will start to do something useful. It will bring stuff. See, I click. If I go to that one, it doesn't actually say that that one's being lit up. Do I need to put another stop over here so that I can move stuff from there over to here? I don't know, but that boat is off. It's going to take like 3 years to get
around. Our former colonial lords have shown their generosity and sent us another vehicle they have no more use for.
More buses and trucks are now available. Outstanding. Okay, that's good. I've now got 16 trucks available and 8 buses available. So let's go to a regular speed at the moment. With these extra trucks, and we've got another cargo ship. Now that makes a big difference. So you're going to stay going on that loop right there, but I'm going to put another one going from that one there back to this one. Or should I go from here back to here? Actually, I think going between these three might be a good one. I don't know if that's actually a positive thing or not, but I think that's what I want to do. I want to be going around those three, because that's going to start moving grain. So the first thing I want to do is get another boat. I need to get another line first. So I will go new line like this, and we'll start off with that one. And then we'll move from there up to that one. And then we will move out to that one over there. And then we'll come into Las Palmas Harbor down here. Perfect. Terminal 1. Right, we've only got Terminal 1 on those. So that one will go there. Then I want to go into here and I want to buy a ship. So this one right here is the one that I want. And I want to go there and I want to set that one on orange. And I want to buy. like that. You're done. Set line all, you're going to go onto line 8. So that one is out and off on its way onto line 8. Then I will come over here and I'm going to purchase another truck down here that's going to work this coal run down here. So I will buy a vehicle. You are an Opal Blitz. Your colour is a blue one for this line, isn't it? Buy. Is there a way to auto set? Right, let's set you onto line 5. Is there a way to auto assign colours and stuff like that? Like onto the vehicles when you're purchasing them? Boats, I can't do an automatic replacement. It won't allow me to do it. So I can't automatically replace the ships just yet. The buses, I can now set an automatic vehicle replacement service on these. So I will go to that one there and I will take the Daimler. Automatic, and that's already set to 25%. So that's on, that's perfect. And then I'm going to go to you, and I'm going to do the same. You're going to be the Daimler Top Seater, and that's going to go on, and you're going to go set to 25% like that. Those two are on. This one, I will do exactly the same again. We will go to you, the Opal Blitz right there. That's the one that I want to replace there. On, and again, 25%. So it's 7.5 years that I'm replacing. I know it's 9 years, ideally, that we want, but I'm happy we're doing it like this. That line down there, line 7, I want to get some more vehicles to go in on line 7. So how do I go? Oh, set. Select color. Ah. Right. So there is a way that I can automatically do it. And replacement on here, I do want to set that. Opal Blitz. There we go, that's that one. Put that on and set that at 25%. There's my vehicles. So I want to buy another vehicle. So I can just go and I don't need to worry about it when I buy the vehicle. I can just do it when I make the purchase. So if I go out and I'll zoom in over here. I'm going to go to you. Buy road vehicle. I want another Opal Blitz. I will buy two of these. One and two. Set line all, line 7. And it automatically sets them. Oh, that is really good. It automatically sets them on the thing. I didn't realize it did that. That is really awesome. Vehicles. Set vehicle color. Blue. I've now set a color on there. It's got a set color. That's fantastic. Right. Okay. There's a quicker way of doing it now. We can now set the... So it's now easy to identify which vehicles are going on which routes. That's something that I want. I'd like to be able to keep that going. So I've got 4 buses available. I've got buses traveling around Santa Cruz, and they are moving passengers around. They're ferrying them around. I got 46 passengers have been out here and back. I've got, right now, I've got 2 more. So it's going to make 48 passengers on there. So we're getting close to being able to have a train up and running. So that will be able to ferry passengers from one place to the next. I'm not going to work with rail cars as well. It'll be one train and 2 rail cars, I'd imagine. So we're going to want to set up like a track. It's just going to go around this main island to start with. I think we'll want anything more than that. Therefore, we're going to want a bus route going around. We'll do Las Puntas next. I'll leave that one. So I'll have 4 buses traveling around on here. I've got 4 buses over in Santa Cruz. Actually, one of them is doing the snack bar run, but what I'm thinking is removing that line completely and then just including all of the other buses on the snack bar run. I might change that as soon as... Well, folks, that's all we've got time for today. We'll be back again very soon, turning yet more pristine natural landscapes into booming industrial wasteland. But before then, if you enjoyed this video, then could you please head down below and give us a like? And if you really enjoyed it, then please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come and watch as well. That would be awesome. And until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.